Hey guys, this is John with Greenfish Nation. Last video we talked about the shad spawn. Well, about the same time that the shad spawn is beginning to end, your bluegill, they're going to start making beds and getting up shallow and doing their thing. And those bass love to eat bluegills, guys. So we're going to talk about the bluegill spawn. It starts about the same water temperature. The water starts getting around 70 to 75 degrees. Those bluegill, they start moving up shallow around boat docks. And if you can find a stump field on a flat that's got a good hard bottom, especially with some little bit of vegetation in it where they feel like they got a little bit of cover where they can kind of hide, you'll be successful. So you guys stay tuned to the baits that we're going to use for the bluegill spawn. All right, guys, during this bluegill spawn, those bass, they'll be trolling up and down the bank there. They'll be raiding those bluegill nests. Those bluegill, they'll bed in groups. I've seen as many as 50 to 75 little nests, kind of like in a colony, you know, all together, and they're just all swimming around doing their thing, and them big bass will come cruising through there, and they'll chase one down, and man, they love them, guys. So what I want to try to do is I want to set up just out from that bluegill bed along a grass line or edge of a creek, somewhere along that flat, even up on the long shallow flat that's far off the bank. I want to get back off the bank. I just love throwing topwaters. It's one of my favorite baits. So just like with the shad spawn, I like to catch them on a popper. Popper keeps you in the strike zone longer. It makes a big commotion, attracts a lot of attention from a long ways. This is a little kin pop. It's kind of in a bluegill pattern, kind of a fire tiger like. It's a pretty good little bait. I've caught a lot of fish off of it. Our next thing I like to throw is I like to get me a chatterbait, especially if I'm setting up out there on the grass flats. Prior to getting to the spawning area, I can work this chatterbait with a little old trailer. I like to throw a little white grub on it. Sometimes I'll dip this grub up here in red. I've got some paint markers, red or blue stripes on it, you know, just kind of liven it up. Maybe throw a little black on the tail. Kind of change it up a little bit, but this right here will pay you dividends as well, especially around heavy wooded cover or lots of vegetation. Another thing I like to throw in those same situations, I like to throw a willow leaf spinner bait. Man, I got my tongue tied there, guys. A willow leaf spinner bait. I like to throw it with some color to it. This has got a chartreuse and a little touch of red on the head. And this is like a pumpkin color with some blue flake in it for the spinner bait. Guys, another good option for heavy cover around these bluegill beds is another Kitech bait. It's like a 3.75. It's got that same green pumpkin with the blue flake in it, and then it's got a little bit of silver on the bottom. That's a real good color. And it's got an underspin for a little bit of added flash. You can bump this thing up off the bottom and let it fall. You can work it through the grass, or you can bang it off of those stumps and lay downs and things and have a lot of success with it. And then we get into our glide bait section. I like to start off with this little rubber glide bait. I'm sorry, I don't know the name of this. I bought a bunch of these at Academy, but man, they really look realistic in the water. You can see it up close. It's got multiple notches in it, and that thing, man, when it swims, it's just through the water just like that. It just looks so realistic. We hammered on the spotted bass up on Broken Bow on these things last summer up around the banks. And then I've got these hard glide baits. You want to choose your size. If you got smaller bluegill, use a smaller one. Try to match the color as well. Let's see if I can hold these without. I've got these colors here, and this is a 4-inch. Depending on where you're at and what your bluegill look like, you can change your bait colors out. I believe this one's red-eyed, and this one's got a gold eye, and this one just has a clear eye with a black dot. But sometimes those eyes are key more than anything, guys. But I hope you guys get out there this summer. It's going to be an exciting time for the bluegill spawn. If you don't ever take a kid fishing, that would be a great time to take some crickets and a bobber as well. After you catch a few of them big bass, let them kids throw a couple times up in that bed and let them pull some of them big bluegills out, and you take them things home and scale them out and clean them, and makes a pretty good meal, and they'll be real proud of themselves. So guys, I hope you've enjoyed today's video. I appreciate you watching it, and until next time, tight lines.